She had long dreamt of visiting the home country of her beloved football player Lionel Messi, Argentina, but she couldn't imagine that her visit to this South American country would become so successful. The 17-year-old fencer Kateryna Chorniy returned home from the Youth Olympics in Buenos Aires as a two-time winner. She returned with full confidence that her success in Argentina is the beginning of future victories in this sport. What does Kateryna Chorniy strive for and dream of achieving in her athletic career? Stay tuned to find out in this program. Zodiac sign, Virgo. Favorite color, pink. Eye color, brown. Favorite season, autumn. Favorite drink, mojito. Favorite animal, dogs. Favorite book, Consuelo by George Sand. Favorite film, Notting Hill. Favorite flower?
Cactus.
A successful athlete can take part in several Olympic Games. Future sports stars can try their skills at the Youth Olympic Games only once in their career. Kateryna Chorniy didn't just try. She bested all her rivals and did what she hadn't been able to do earlier at adult tournaments at the World Cup level. And then she climbed up to the highest step of the winner's podium, once again with the European team to receive her second gold medal. Needless to say, when I hold this medal in my hands, I'm very satisfied with my achievement and proud of it. Actually, Kateryna Chorniy's trip to Argentina was a big if. She didn't win a ticket at the Youth Olympic selection, losing to her rival in the 1/8 final of the Cadet World Cup. But then she was one of the last to get the opportunity to go to compete in Argentina after one of the countries turned down its participation quota. That was my last year as a cadet and the last competition at the cadet level. Yes, there was probably too many negative emotions, and the rep year suffered from that a bit. Then it dawned on me that I would not be going to the Olympics, and I felt quite down emotionally. But when I later found out that I would go, I was so excited to have the chance to compete at this highest level. Kateryna Chorniy was in the subway when she found out that she would get a second chance to prove herself at the Olympics. She burst into tears of joy despite all the strangers around. At the moment, I received the good news. I was on the subway with my close friends. My dad called and said, "You know, Kateryna, I told you that I believed in you and that you would go to the Olympics." I asked, "What Olympics?" And he said, "Yes, the Olympics, so pack up your bags." I was so happy that I burst into tears. I really wanted to go to Argentina for the competitions and to visit Buenos Aires. It was my dream, and now I have great feelings. Kateryna Chorniy came to her championship titles with her coach Dmytro Raislin, with whom she's been working since her first steps in fencing. Dmytro usually took talented athletes at the age of 15 to 16. It was different with Kateryna Chorniy. He first saw her do well when she was 9, and they have been totally inseparable since that moment. It's a rare case when I immediately see the prospects of an athlete. She's a very well physically coordinated girl. By the way, when she was still a child, she came to training on a skateboard, unlike the other athletes. We've been working together for about 8 years. There is such a thing as a children's league in fencing. They start fencing from the age of 9. So she spent 3 or 4 years fencing in the children's league and didn't lose a single start. She won absolutely all matches at the level of state competitions. But being the best in Ukraine is one thing, while becoming the best of the world is completely different. Before the Youth Olympics in Argentina, Kateryna Chorniy had achieved the status of promising fencers who fought for a rise to the podium. In Buenos Aires, she defeated all her rivals. She fenced with the strongest athletes at the world championship level and with the world champion. She had been losing those fights, but then won with a decisive strike. Her character is the most important thing, and she's also quite agile and crafty for her age. But her character, I once said that she snaps her enemy's spines merely by looking them in the eyes. She's a real fighter and always goes for the win. Kateryna Chorniy stands out from among her other rivals by her height. She grew to be quite a tall girl since childhood and could engage in any kind of sports with a height of 184 centimeters. And that's how it was before fencing. I tried many sports. Among them were swimming, volleyball, and of course basketball. But then I came to fencing and stayed after having tried out all those other sports. On top of that, she was probably destined to become a fencer. Her grandfather was a saber fencer and today is a coach and a successful performer at veteran tournaments. He bears his champion title with dignity. Kateryna Chorniy's mother was also an épée fencer. Her older sister attended fencing classes for quite a number of years, and only her father was into rowing back in his days. I came there when I was 9, and it interested me at the time with people in white costumes holding some weapons and quickly moving around. Then it gradually became an integral part of my life, and I realized how cool it was. It's truly a cool sport. It allows you to develop yourself both physically and mentally, so I think it's really cool in that regard. If you're growing up in a family of fencers and going to fencing classes, you can imagine that Kateryna Chorniy talks about fencing not just when training and at competitions, but also at home. Supporting her and showing concern for her is welcome, but there is absolutely no need to teach her fencing at home. It was possible before, but now I say thanks. I've got a coach and I will discuss this matter with him. In terms of sports morale, that's only a plus, but we don't talk about fencing. I have Dmitro, and that's the only person with whom I discuss matters when it comes down to fencing. Her coach has a good fencing school under his belt. Even though Dmitro Raislin couldn't decide between fencing and basketball, in the end he coached many generations of Ukrainian fencers. He never trained such girls as tall as Kateryna Chorniy. However, Dmitro highlights different aspects of her character and physique. That's just anthropometry. You know, taller height means less movement frequency, though that doesn't concern her, since she's still very quick in her movements. But as for her character, she won the Youth Olympics by sheer force of her character. We found out that we were going to the Olympics quite late, so we didn't have enough time to train properly for them. The cheerful nature is an exceptional feature of the Ukrainian fencer. She was smiling even when she was coming out to compete in the decisive fights of the Youth Olympics. That was very conspicuous on the backdrop of the gloomy faces of her rivals. I realized that I could either smile or have such a gloomy face, but that would not change anything. So I just tried to come to a fight with a positive attitude and a smile on my face. What happens during the fight, when I'm wearing the mask, whether I'm smiling or crying, doesn't matter. The only thing that really matters is what I'm going to do during the fight. Kateryna Chorniy did everything perfectly in the fencing ring in Buenos Aires. She did that automatically. She knows about what happened there mostly from what those who were nearby told her. I remember almost nothing from what happened there because it was a moment of shock. I only remember hearing the national anthem. Then I calmed down a bit. Then the anthem ended, we took some photos and left. All that is left are just positive feelings, but I remember nothing that happened inside the fencing ring. Honestly speaking, I would like to return there to finally feel and understand the feelings of that moment. Kateryna's triumph in Argentina gave her a second win. Now she dreams of great victories in the fencing ring, and she's confident that there is a great success ahead in her future. She continues to train more in order to achieve her plans and fulfill her ultimate dreams. I think it's one of the steps towards major victories, so I want to train more, because it's actually very pleasant and can easily and very quickly be forgotten. It's just 1 minute if you're climbing up onto the pedestal, listening to your country's national anthem, and then leaving the arena. But I really want to feel the thrill of victory once again, so I definitely won't stop here. The athlete's coach admits that he definitely went to Argentina to bring home a medal, possibly even a gold one, but he didn't think that there would be two of them. He was in cloud nine in Buenos Aires. He realized a lot about the future prospects of his trainee there. I didn't see a medal, I saw quality. I realized that it wasn't the last medal, which is more important to me. We've been working for a long time with my colleagues. It's not the first Olympic medal we've won. The fact that we will probably win something in the adult Olympics is also very inspiring, possibly even at the Olympics themselves.
The
The Youth Olympics radically changed the life of Kateryna Chorniy. The 17-year-old fencer felt increased attention to her persona immediately after landing at the airport. Interviews and autographs have become an integral part of her life. The coach is worried that it could affect the attitude of his trainee in doing her best in her favorite sport. The media, awards, congratulations, ministers meeting her, and so on. A weak soul could have gone crazy, but I don't think it'll happen to her because she's a smart girl and has a strong will. It's a very simple concept. Maybe because it's pleasant after all, right? This attention probably makes her happy, but she'll probably want to experience it again and again. It's a kind of drug. But I honestly believe that everything will be fine with Kateryna. The athlete herself admits that she hasn't changed at all after winning in Argentina, and the fame, autograph sessions, interviews and photo shoots are a pleasant bonus that she wants to continue exploiting in the future thanks to her results. Nothing has changed in my life. I still go to school, sleep in the same place, and I live with the same parents. Maybe it's different in terms of autographs and journalists, but I understand that it will end soon, and there will be the next competitions, so not much has changed. Kateryna has long dreamt of going to Argentina, since she fell in love with the playing style of the Argentinian football player Lionel Messi. My favorite football player is the native Argentinian Lionel Messi. That's why I've always dreamt of Argentina. I thought if I visited, I would gain some inspiration to work toward victories. And yes, Argentina is a cool country. It is very colorful and sunny. But I like my native Ukraine more. Many sports idols of Kateryna Chorniy live and train in Ukraine. Moreover, they train with her, so she can talk to them and ask for her advice as a highly respected athlete. I really like our Ukrainian national team. If you have questions about an A-page or a saber, you can talk to Olha Harlan. In any case, there is someone to look up to, and the girls I train with, both of them are going to be on the adult national team. I'm always very pleased to listen to them and train with them. So yes, we most definitely have idols, and they're all native Ukrainians. Reading books is in first place among Kateryna Chorniy's hobbies. The books must definitely be printed, since she doesn't like electronic ones. She prefers flipping the pages and going back to reread the moments she liked. She always has a book in her backpack. Now she's reading Heaven Has No Favorites by Remark. I really like reading, and I also like drawing. I like doing what develops me as a person. That's mostly not sports, because I have enough of it during training. I'm not against active hobbies, but I prefer drawing, reading, possibly watching some movies, listening to some cool music, and even going to the theater with friends. I like it all. This year, the champion of the Youth Olympics is graduating from school. Her peers are already thinking about what dress to wear to the prom, where to do their makeup and hairstyle. Kateryna has other concerns. I am actually preparing for exams instead of the prom, because the exams are going to be difficult, and I want to pass them with flying colors. I don't want to reinforce the stereotype that athletes are a bit behind the people who constantly study. So the dress is not a priority. I'll take care of that when the prom is approaching. From time to time, the girl with a model appearance and height of 184 centimeters is offered to take certain steps in the model business. Kateryna was not against that earlier. I used to dream of that, but mom said she wouldn't let me. But I'm glad I'm an athlete. Maybe sometime later I'll do a photo shoot, but I don't think it's something professional. No offense to models. Day after day, Kateryna Chorniy spends time and energy to achieve her sports dream. The ultimate dream of a fencer is participation and victory in the Olympics. She reached the top in the Youth Olympics, and now she dreams of winning a medal in the Adult Olympics. I hope that the picture that I keep seeing in my head becomes reality. I really hope it does. I'll work hard for that. I just want to be happy, but I don't know what kind of occupation would do that for me. Maybe that's coaching, maybe something else. I just want to be happy. The upcoming Olympics in Tokyo are likely to take place without the participation of Kateryna Chorniy. After all, the fencing competition among Ukrainian women is too high. However, the winner of the Youth Olympics in Argentina can definitely count on the Games in Paris in 2024.